Hi, let me very quickly demonstrate you a couple of use cases. So we've got a reaction picker component that gets possible reactions via dedicated signal input. This is pretty dynamic story, right? Because we can provide more or less reaction options via this input. We also have a selected reaction signal, which stores the last reaction selected by a user, or it contains null if nothing is selected. The problem we have currently is that when the list of reactions changes, the selected reaction isn't reset back to null, containing an already invalid value that is not present in the current reactions list anymore. The second use case is kind of variation of the first one. So imagine that you want to have a certain reaction from the reactions input pre-selected initially. For example, I want to pre-select the latest reaction in the array by default, which unfortunately didn't happen, as you can see. Even more, if you try to do the same thing with the required signal input, your application will fail with runtime error because the input signal value isn't available at constructor time. In this video, you will learn pretty much everything you have to know about the brand new experimental reactive primitive called LinkedSignal that appears for the first time in Angular 19, and in really elegant way, it solves the issues I demonstrated a couple of moments ago. If it is your first time on my channel, my name is Dmytro Mozhensky, and I create advanced Angular tutorials and courses, helping people to become senior Angular developers who clearly understand what they're doing and how things are really working. I already covered a lot of unique and advanced Angular topics in the past, so you can check them out later, but now let's talk about LinkedSignal and let's learn more about this new reactive primitive. All right, let's continue and address the issue with the default reaction selection in the first place. But before we continue, we have to figure out why it is not working right now. This might be pretty obvious for those who already has some experience with the new reactivity system in Angular, so you can skip this part of the video. But for those who are very new to Angular, I will provide some context. So the problem lies in how we resolve the default value for the selected reaction signal. This resolution happens during the constructor phase, which means that the component input values have not been resolved yet. So at this point, the reactions property holds its initial value, which is an empty array. And as a result, the attempt to get the last element of the empty array returns undefined, which is then converted to a null value for the selected reaction signal. Then, when initial input binding happens and the reactions input is eventually populated with an array of reactions, this expression isn't recalculated because it is not part of the reactive context. This is why we see the reactions rendered, but the selection wasn't synchronized with this last change and remains null. There are multiple ways how to place it in the reactive context. The most obvious would be usage of the effect function, but usage of effect is strongly discouraged by the Angular team. Maybe I will make a separate video about the reasons why you should avoid the effect function, but for now, we simply don't consider it as an option. So another way to derive a value reactively from another signal would be the usage of the computed function, which would wrap our expression right here, and this would cause the value recomputation for the selected reaction signal whenever the reactions signal changes. So I would always have the last reaction pre-selected in this case. However, the computed function returns a read-only signal, which will cause an error in my case, because I'm trying to set a new value, a new selected reaction for this signal later at runtime, and namely when the user clicks the corresponding reaction. And this is where LinkedSignal come into play, but before you see it in action, please remember that this feature is still in developer preview and is not ready for production yet. Anyway, let's try to apply LinkedSignal instead of computed and see what will happen. So my application is back. And what is even more important is that the last reaction is pre-selected right now. And it doesn't matter how many reactions I have, whenever the list of reactions changes, the last reaction is always kept selected by default. Works the same way as computed, right? But important is that unlike computed, it allows you to change the derived value later at any time. So I can click any other reaction from the list and set a new value for the selected reaction signal. And I can continue changing it as long as I want. However, whenever any of the signals inside the linked signal callback changes, it will cause value recomputation, which will override or reset the current linked signal state with what this expression returns. In my case, whenever reaction is currently selected, the change of the reaction signal input will reset the selected reaction signal to the last option in the reactions array. So to summarize, we can say that you can think of linked signal as a computed with two main differences. The first one is that derived value in linked signal can be overridden. This is what you have currently seen. The second difference is that unlike computed, the linked signal gives you access to the previous signal value. And if you continue watching, you will see this in action as well. And by the way, if you are still not confident with these new reactive primitives in Angular, like computed, signal, etc., I have a dedicated video where I cover all of them and you can check it out later. The link will be up there. Anyway, let's dive into linked signal even more. Important to mention is that the linked signal has multiple notations, and the alternative to current notation would be providing the configuration object where you define two things. The first one is a source property, and it's supposed to be a function that returns a signal or a group of signals, change of which one we are going to track. In my case, this is the only reactions signal. The second property is computation, which is actually the function that will be executed every time the value of the source signal changes. And then what this expression returns will be eventually the value of the selected reaction signal. By the way, using this notation, you don't have to access the source signal directly in the computation function, but instead you will get the source signal value as the first argument of the computation function. So in such a way, we achieve the same result, but with more explicit notation. This more explicit notation is very convenient for solving another use case that I showed you at the beginning of this video. Namely, if you want to reset the value back to null or any other value whenever the list of reaction changes. With this notation, it is as simple as just returning null for the computation function. And that's it. Oh, actually, not so easy. The problem is that we have to adjust also types for the linked signal, because since I return only null from the computation function, by default, linked signal infers the type as a writable signal of value null only, which is not the case in my particular situation, because I can have also strings as a value for the selected reaction. So that's why we have to explicitly define the type, which is actually generic, that consists of two parameters. The first parameter describes the type of the source, which is, in my case, is array of string that matches actually the reactions input. And the second parameter in this generic type describes the value of the linked signal itself. In my case, again, it might be a string if some reaction is selected, or it is null if nothing is selected, right? So now we can save our change and we see that the error is gone. And now you can see that I can select any reaction, but when I change the value of the reaction's input signal, the value of the selected reaction resets to null, which is really cool. This video, by the way, was inspired by exactly this use case question about which one was raised on my Discord server, where me and more than 1,000 awesome Angular developers around the world just discuss different Angular topics, having fun, etc. And you can join us as well. This is absolutely free. You just have to scan this QR code or follow the link in the video description and join our awesome community. So we will be happy to meet you there. But anyway, let's continue and make our use case even more complex. Imagine that you want to calculate a value of the linked signal based on the previous one. For example, I want to keep the selected reaction if it exists in the new array of reactions, but if the new array doesn't contain a reaction that is currently selected, then we reset the value for the linked signal back to null. Okay, so to solve this issue, I would additionally need to use the second argument of the computation function, which contains the previous linked signal state. The state here is represented by the previous source value and the value of the linked signal itself. All right, so we can even see it in action if we try to console log it and look up how it looks in real life and how it changes over time. So currently you can see that the value is undefined, which means that this is the first invocation of the computation function. But if I try to show more reactions, we will see the following picture. The property source inside the previous object contains the previous value of the source signal, okay? And the value here is the previous value of the linked signal itself. And having this information, we can do actually a lot of cool things, including the feature I would like to implement before. For example, we could iterate through the current source value, which contains my current reactions, and I can try to find the reaction I had previously selected. So if I can find it, I return it as a new value for the linked signal, right? If not, I simply return null, as easy as that. So now, if I try to select any reaction here and then add more reactions, you can see that the neutral face remains selected because it is present in this new set of reactions, all right? But if I choose this one and then reduce the number of reactions, it will be reset to null because the previous reaction isn't included in this new set of reactions. And to not have the invalid value, we simply reset it back to null. Alright guys, thanks for watching this video until the end. If you want to explore new features from Angular 19, I highly recommend you my previous video about resource API. The link will appear somewhere here. And this is one of my favorite features in Angular 19. Check it out, definitely it worth it. If you want to learn some Angular topics in depth, like Angular forms, please check out my video courses. Link will be in the video description. From there, you will learn a lot of cool stuff, really. Otherwise, I would kindly ask you to share this video with your colleagues and friends. If you find this video useful, please leave your thoughts, leave your comments. I always read them. I try to answer them whenever I can. Enjoy the rest of the week and see you in the next video.